Dwemer certainly knew how to build for the ages. These towers have outlasted their creators by millennia. The book is housed inside that dome. I'll need to unlock the door for us. Let's get on with it.
The Skull have always avoided rumors such as these. Nothing of the Allmaker is to be found within.
The Dwemer of Nchardak appear to have been fond of these control pedestals. Luckily, I found a cube to operate it inside on my last visit. I sealed the door when I left to keep out ignorant meddlers. Let me unlock it. The book is just inside. And see the book right here. So tantalizingly close. But trust me, no magic will open that. I'd have had the book already if it could.
The dwarves must have feared this book to lock it away like this.
No, we'll have to do this the hard way. If we can restore the steam supply to this room, I'm certain I can open it. As you'll see, that's easier said than done. This way, to the boilers. Follow me. Last time I was here, I only explored a small part of the ruins. I was here alone then, and I find an assistant is absolutely essential for this kind of dirty, dangerous work. Nchardak, the city of 100 towers. In its day, it was the largest of the great Dwemer archives, and perhaps the most advanced. In the old stories, when the Nords came to conquer it, It said the Dwemer submerged the entire city beneath the sea until the invaders gave up. I have my doubts, but the city was a marvel of Dwemer engineering. Now reduced to this.
Amazing to think they built this so long ago. Still it survives.
As you can see, most of the lower levels of the city are flooded, but it isn't hopeless. The old Dwemer pumps still seem to work. Watch. But the pumps only operate when a cube is in the pedestal. And unfortunately, they only have one cube. These four boilers provide steam to the room upstairs. They're shut down, but they still respond to the control cubes. So, if we can find four more cubes, we can turn these boilers back on and restore steam power to the room upstairs. Then I should be able to open the book's protective case. Bring that cube. We'll need it. Yes, here we are. This device shows the location of four more cubes. This section of the city. It looks like most of the cubes were moved to the lower levels, perhaps to try to control the flooding before the city was abandoned. Interesting. That would suggest that the city must have originally sunk during the first cataclysm of Red Mountain. Or that the Dwemer's servitors continued to try to preserve the city after their creator's disappearance. Three of the cubes are through here. This seems like a sensible place to start. You should be able to unseal this door with the control cube I gave you. The rest of the cubes are this easy to find, although knowing a Dwemer, I rather doubt it. These must be the great workshops of Nechardak. Impressive, even in ruins. In the city's days of glory, it was reputed to be able to assemble a complete automaton in a single day. Much of the Dwemer's army at the Battle of Red Mountain must have come from here.
It is rather impressive.
Ah! That's correct. I'm glad to see someone else has been paying attention. Last cube is somewhere in here. I hope it won't require more swimming around in this filth. I'd guess that must be the pump activator up there. But how to reach it? We'll need to get all three of these bridges down in order to reach the pump control.
I think you did it.
That's it. Don't touch anything else. Quickly now.
You all? Sure!
Someone there!
I'll make a protection!
No? Sure! I retrieve from the pumping pedestal, we should now have 5 cubes, exactly what we need. Now we can finally see about getting those boilers started. Here, I picked up this cube for you. Shall we get on with it? Thank you. You need to start the 4 boilers. Then we should be able to open the water protective case upstairs. Was worth it. Please be my guest. You deserve the first look. Besides, it could be very dangerous. These books are known to drive many people insane. Oh, good. Be sure to say hello to Hermes Mora for me.
Well done, my champion. Your journey towards enlightenment has finally led you here to my realm, as I knew it would. You have entered my realm. You have sought out the forbidden knowledge that only one other has obtained. You are dragonborn, like Mirak before you, a seeker of knowledge and power. From me. I know what you want. To use your power as Dragonborn, to bend the world to your will. Here then, use the knowledge you need, although you did not know you needed it. The second word of power. Use it to bend the wills of mortals to your purpose. But this is not enough. Mirak knows the final word of power. Without that, you cannot hope to surpass him. Mirak served me well, and he was rewarded. I can grant you the same power as he wields, but all knowledge has its price. Knowledge for knowledge. The Skaar have withheld their secrets from me for many long years. The time has come for this knowledge to be added to my library. I know you will, and then I will give you the knowledge that you seek. Send the Skaar Shaman to me. He holds the secrets that will be mine.
Different people have very different experiences when reading these books. You're still acting surprisingly sane, too. What did he have to say? He must have wanted something from you. Ah, what secrets could they have worth keeping from old Mora? Sounds like a bargain to me. Hermaeus Mora learns some fascinating new ways to skin a hawker, and you become the second most powerful dragonborn that ever lived. Well, that gives me a lot to think about. I need to get back to Talmithran. I have some ideas about how to locate more of these black books.